Hey guys, so today's video is going to be my July favorites, and I know it's been a while since I've been on this camera, and let's pause and have a story time for like 5 minutes, and let me update you, because if you don't follow me on my Twitter or Instagram, you have absolutely no idea what I've been doing. So, I know I haven't posted a video since last Monday, I am so sorry. Last Friday, I found out I was going to LA on Monday, and it was a very last minute trip, and I was like going bananas, and I had no idea what I was gonna pack, what I was gonna do. I had to find a pet sitter, so I was super busy, I couldn't even pre-film. And then I was in LA for a week. Friday, when I got back, this past Friday, I had plane issues, and so I didn't get my luggage until yesterday, which is Tuesday, and it was just a whole big mess. But also, my now boyfriend is in town, and I mentioned this in my last Q&A, I believe, and he is leaving on Sunday to go back to school, so I'm just spending time with him and just trying to make the best of what we have right now. But I really am so sorry. I hate leaving you guys like that. That's why I make sure I update you guys on Twitter and Instagram so you know what I'm doing, where I'm at, and I've been making sure that I kept you guys updated. So if you don't follow me on social media, I will link them down below in the description box. But today we are doing my July favorites, and I am so excited about it because I have quite a few favorites. I mean, I don't have like a ton of stuff, but these things I really do love, and I have some songs for you, so let's get started. The first thing I want to mention is kind of random, but it's shoes. I have two pairs of shoes. The first ones are these from Vince Camuto. I just love fringe booties, and I can even wear these into the fall time. I love them. So again, they're Vince Camuto, and they're kind of like wedges, but they're not wedges because they're a heel, but they're really, really comfortable, and the fringe is just adorable, and I love them. I think they look cute with pretty much anything. I mean, these are amazing. And then, as most of you know, I have been working out a ton lately. These past couple months, I have just been going crazy in the gym with my trainer. And I just really quickly want to say thank you guys so much for all the positive comments you sent my way, talking about how you can tell I've toned up and how happy I look. Thank you so much, because one of the biggest things that I really needed to work on was working out and getting back to feeling good and just feeling good about myself, and I'm finally there, and it's just getting better with working out. So thank you guys so much for all of your positive feedback. I want to talk about these shoes because I love them. I do have quite a few pairs of Nikes just because I've collected them over the years, and I love Nike. Nike's just my favorite brand. They are not sponsoring me for this video. I wish they would, but they're not. But these Nikes are my favorite. I got them before the Nordstrom semi-annual sale. Is that what they call it? I can't remember. But I'm a, what, card member or something, so I got to look early, and I got these on sale. They're the Nike Free 5.0, the Nike Free TR Flyknit. I don't know. These are awesome. I absolutely love them. So if you're wondering where I got them from, I did get them from Nordstrom. Just like look up Nike 5.0s on Nordstrom and see if they have them. But I love this like knitted look that it has. I think it's really cool. And I love these for when I'm doing weights or even squats, because my feet don't go over the sides of the shoe. Sometimes I have that issue where I have such a wide foot that it will just like go over the sides. But I don't have that issue with these. They're really, really lightweight. Probably shouldn't be touching the bottom, but these are my favorite workout shoes at the moment. Highly, highly recommend them. Other random thing before we get onto the makeup is this. I did not expect to like this as much as I do, but I think it's amazing. It's the Victoria's Secret Bombshell Hair and Body Mist. I mainly gravitated towards this because it did say hair mist, and like I said, I've been working out a lot, so I don't wash my hair every single day. Like right now, it's greasy, and I just washed it yesterday, but I sweat so much at the gym that I'm just like, ooh. Usually I have my hair up in a bun for a majority of the week, but this is great. Even when I have my hair in a ponytail for the gym, I can just take it and spray it. I'm pretty sure this has like some sort of oil in it because I can see it right now. So I wouldn't put like a ton of this in your hair because it would probably make it really oily if you have a naturally oily scalp as it is, which I do. But just a couple spritz in the ends just really makes a huge difference. And when I'm working out, sometimes my ponytail will whip me in the face and I'm just like, so moving on to makeup, this is the main reason why I had to wait until my luggage got here, because all my favorite makeup products were in my luggage. And I was like, the one time I don't put it in carry-on, I don't have it. So this is one of my all-time favorite palettes right now. I think it's amazing. This is the e.l.f. Made for Matte palette. So it's an all matte neutral palette, and I love this. It has warm tones, cool tones. It's very pigmented. I did use this in my last Get Ready talk through video, so I will leave that down below if you haven't seen it. I absolutely love the way that the look turned out. It was beautiful. These blend really well. Again, they're very, very pigmented, and I just love them. That's just from one swipe. Like, that's amazing. So this is one of my favorite shades as well. I think it's just, it's so worth the money. I've had a lot of people ask me where I got mine, and I purchased it offline. I haven't seen them in stores or anything, but I'm pretty sure this was like $5. I can't quite remember because I did make a pretty big e.l.f. order, but that palette is a must-have. You gotta have it in your life. So last month, I think I mentioned to you guys I was obsessed with Estee Lauder Double Wear again, which I love that foundation. We all know I love that foundation. I think it's beautiful. But this month, I went back to the Too Faced, but oh, Better Than Sex? No. The Too Faced Born This Way foundation. I love this foundation, you guys. I think it is beautiful on the skin. It looks like skin. It's not as heavy as the Double Wear. Then again, it doesn't last as long as the Double Wear, but that's not what it's intended for. It's not intended for the longevity like the Double Wear has. I love it. Right now, I'm mixing vanilla and honey just because I have a few shades. But my shade when I'm nice and self-tanned, which is not right now, I actually need to self-tan, is warm beige. So every other time you see me self-tanned, this is a shade that I use, and I love it. And I love, love, love it with this Makeup Geek Foundation Stippling Brush and the Beauty Blender. It's my two favorite ways to apply this foundation. I just think it's so insanely beautiful. Okay, so the next thing I want to quickly mention is the Becca Cosmetics Champagne Pop Highlighter that Jaclyn Hill did collab with Becca to make, and I do think this is an amazing highlighter. I have seen it everywhere, and it's everywhere for a reason because it is stunning. I really do love it. It's like the perfect shade. It's stunning. I think it's going to be beautiful for any time of the year. I just love the glow that it gives to my skin. I mean, you need this highlighter in your life. If you are a highlighter junkie, even if you're not a highlighter junkie and you just want one really good highlighter, Becca has amazing ones, and this champagne one is amazing. So check that out. Also, speaking of new items, I have been trying out this Urban Decay Brow Tamer. It's a flexible hold tinted brow gel. Usually I use the Anastasia brow gel in brunette. I absolutely love it. I have no issues with it, but I've just been trying out this one and I really like it. They are tinted. I usually use the warm brown one, but I love the packaging of this. I think it's really sleek and pretty, and it's great for travel. It's really, really simple. But what I love about this is I like the fact that it's not too strong of a hold. I do have crazy eyebrows, but sometimes when I put different brow gels on my brows, it looks a little crazy, and sometimes it gets a little flaky, and these do not do that. So I highly recommend them. They're awesome. Again, they're the Urban Decay Brow Tamers, and they're the tinted kind. They also have a clear one as well if you don't like tinted brow gels. I like tinted brow gels because I feel like if you don't fill in an area as well as you did other parts on your brow, you could put a little bit more of that brow gel right there and it kind of blends in together. But it's just personal preference, whatever you want to do. The most exciting part of anything this month is these new Kat Von D liquid lipsticks. The moment I saw her post on Instagram that she had these new colors out, I just went straight to Sephora on my phone and I purchased these. So let's just talk about the favorites. My top two favorites are these two. This pink one is called Melancholia. I am not too sure. This is what it looks like. I have these two right now mixed on my lips. So this is, it's a darker baby pink shade. And usually I don't like these kinds of shades, but I really, really, really love this one. And like I said, I mixed it with this one, which is called Bow and Arrow, which I knew I was gonna love. The moment I saw it, I was like, yes, that is my kind of color. I love it because I feel like Lolita is great for people who really wanna get more into the brown mauves that are like really bold. This one is not too bold. I feel like this is a great everyday darker nude. It's not too intense. And then we have these two, which I love as well. This one's a little bit lighter, so I just used this in the center of my lips. Well, not right now, but earlier I used it in the center of my lips, and it looked beautiful blended out with everything. I, like, mixed so many colors earlier. But this is in Requiem, R-E-Q-U-I-E-M. It's an It's like an ashy lilac pink. And then this one's gorgeous too. It's called Lovesick. Again, these all dry matte. If you don't know about these Kat Von D liquid lipsticks, they are just amazing. You can see this one's like more of a darker pink. I love these liquid lipsticks. I already have a few from her and I think they're just so amazing. And these colors are stunning. So if you have not seen her new shades, go check them out right now. Also, for new lip products, I am so happy Urban Decay came out with a matte lipstick. Oh, this is actually, I'm going to talk about the liner first. This is the Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Lip Pencil in 1993. This lip pencil is so amazing because it really is very, very creamy, but so long wearing. It's just, it feels so good on the lips. It's not tugging or anything, so it really helps you get that sharp line. And I love the color. The color is just perfection. And then the lipstick 1993 is amazing as well. It is a matte shade and it matches, of course, the liner. But that's, I love darker nudes and that is stunning. And it is matte, but it's creamy. So it's not going to dry out your lips like as much as the Kat Von D ones. And yeah, it's just awesome. And I love the packaging. I just think Urban Decay is killing it right now. I mean, I've received some new products from them that I'm just obsessed with. I also did get this from them. They did send this to me for PR. This is the Urban Decay Naked Smoky Palette. I have not used it yet. If you guys want me to do a kind of get ready chit chat video like I did last time with new products, but with this one, let me know in the comments and I will do that. I haven't even touched this palette. It's just sitting there waiting to be used. So let me know in the comments and I could do maybe like a first impression, chit chat, get ready video and show you guys how I'm loving it. And then really quickly, I want to mention this NYX Matte Liquid Liner. This is awesome. This is so good. I'm running out of my Makeup Forever Matte Liquid Liner and I saw this one and I was like, okay, I'll give it a shot. The only thing I don't really like about it is the brush tip. I'm not a huge brush tip kind of person, but look at how black this is. Golly, it is so black. It looks shiny right now, but once it dries matte, I mean, there is no shine whatsoever. Very great liner. It's from the drugstore. You can't beat it. I love NYX. I feel like NYX has been killing it too. NYX and e.l.f. have just been prime. Then I really quickly want to mention a lash glue. Over the weekend, I wanted to wear false lashes, but of course I didn't have my duo lash glue because it was in my bag. But I went to Publix and picked this up because it was the only one that they had, and it's the Ardell Lash Grip Eyelash Adhesive. And like I said, I was really nervous about this. This is the clear kind, which I usually do like dark tone duo lash glue. I was so nervous about this, but let me tell you, once you let this get tacky, it stays on your eyes and your lash is not going anywhere. And the clear does dry pretty clear, so I like this. If you're looking for a new lash glue, definitely try this one out. I think it's so good and it lasts for 24 months. That's a long time. So that is actually all of my makeup favorites for the month. I want to show you guys these up close. That's how they all look matte. I'm just a matte kind of girl, can you tell? That is so beautiful. Oh, I love it. So we're gonna go ahead and just move on to music favorites because that's all we got left. And music favorites are my favorite parts of these videos, so I of course have to do this. I don't know if I announced this last month or if I just made my Spotify public after my favorites video, but my Spotify playlist is public. You guys have been going ham on my Spotify, sending me tweets and just going crazy. So thank you guys so much. I'm glad you enjoy my music taste. I take pride in music. I think music is a really big thing. I have a few new different things. If you follow me, you can see when I add new songs to my playlist. My Workout to Workout is probably my most used playlist and my current favorites also. So if you ever want to know like my current favorite songs, you can just go to current favorites and it'll show you all of them. All Eyes on You by Meek Mill. Okay, first off, Meek or Drake? Meek or Drake? Let me know in the comments who do you prefer? I mean, I heard Back to Back and I was like, I've always been a Drake fan, so I'm sorry Meek, but gotta go with Drake. But this Meek Mill song, All Eyes on You with Chris and Nicki, is just phenomenal, so you know I love it. Yeah, yeah, baby, is you
Are you here looking for love? Got the club going crazy. All these bitches but my eyes on you.
What's your name?
My name Nick.
Where you from?
New York and this bitch.
Moving on. This one is called On to Something Good by Ashley Monroe. This is country and I love this song. Okay, so this song is called Strip It Down by Luke Bryan. I also mentioned this in my Getting Ready Talk Through video. I'm so obsessed with this song, you guys. You have to listen to it. Again, it is country, but it's amazing.
Strip it down, back to you and me, like it used to be, when it was an old back road with an old school beat, cowboy boots by your little bare feet.
Also, I have been loving 679 by Fetty Wap. I mean, obviously, I've been loving this song, and it's just so good. It just makes me so happy. One that I actually just found, but I've been wearing it out. I'm probably gonna hate it next month, but I love it. It is called Jordan Belfort, and it's by Wes Walker. It's just, when you first listen to it, you're like, what the hell? But it's so good. Just give it a few seconds.
I've been getting dirty money, Jordan Belfort. Stacking penny stocks while I'm flipping these birds. Sipping on Ciroc, trip them up with the words. Jordan Belfort. Jordan Belfort.
Okay, guys, so that is it for my music favorites and beauty favorites and random things for the month. I'm so sorry again that this video is late, but at least it's up, right? I was planning on actually filming this and having it up like last weekend, but since I didn't have my luggage, I couldn't do that. So I'm sorry, but I will get back to filming videos for you guys. You'll see a new one from me very, very soon. Leave some comments down below letting me know what you want to see, if you want to see that naked palette in action and different things like that. And don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!